What is up, guys? I am Dr. Murdershot, and welcome back to my Tomb Raider walkthrough on the Xbox 360. Now, we are going to actually be going over the menus today, but before we do that, I want to head back over here to tell you guys about the Ghost Skull Challenges. Now, what the Ghost Skull Challenges are, basically, you get these little skulls over here that you have to shoot down with the arrows, or hopefully with whatever you have, as long as it's a weapon. You have to shoot those skulls right there down. Well, not down, but you have to shoot them. And it will basically just trigger the challenge. And all you have to do for the challenge is find 10 other skulls, or as many skulls that it will actually tell you to find. And they're around pretty much the same area, so they should be easy to find. But anyway, let us get into the menus. Now, the first menu here is the camp menu, as well as the relic and pretty much everything else, as you can see there. It will tell you what you have found and what you haven't found. It will also show you the area once you have found it of where you found it. See what I'm saying? Now, the thing about this menu is once you finish the game, you can actually use your fast travel ability to travel between the camps. But I think it's really stupid though, because you should be able to fast travel, you know, when you're actually playing the game, not after you beat it. But hey, that's how the game is made. Now for the next menu, this is your skill tree menu. Here you will use your skill points to actually upgrade your skills. And pretty much you can upgrade whatever skill you want. You have the survivor, you have the hunter, and you have the brawler skill. So you can go ahead and look through that, but I need to move on to the next menu. So go ahead and look through it if you want. Now the next menu is the upgrading menu. Here's where you will upgrade your weapons and gear. And that's pretty much what you have to do. Just find some parts, some gears, break some boxes, and upgrade your weapons here. Now this is just the relics menu. Here you can just see your relics. You can go back to your relic if you pick one, and you can read about it. Everything here is just self-explanatory. And here you will read about your documents. And that's pretty much it. Like I said, it's really self-explanatory. If you find documents, you can come back here and read them again. But other than that, there's nothing to it. The menus are important, but they're not that important. So other than that, let's just move on. Now we are going to go over here and receive our first weapon, which will be the bow. After we get the bow, we are going to be looking for the rest of these skulls, as well as kill some animals for the achievement, because we need to get 3 achievements around this area. And the 3 achievements will be, you know, will be Big Game Hunter, which is kill and loot 10 large animals like deer, boars, and wolves. Taste Like Chicken, kill and loot 10 small animals like rabbits, chicken, and rats. Feather Duster, which is kill and loot 10 flying animals, crows, and gulls. They're pretty easy to get. All you have to do is just shoot the animals. But be careful, do not waste your arrows. I mean, you could get your arrows back once you actually enter the warehouse thing, and you can just come back and I think they will respawn. Once you enter this house right here, you can just go all the way through and then come back to the area, and I think that they will actually respawn. But for now, just don't waste them because you are gonna need them. But let me just jack this guy for his arrow real quick.
I can do this.
Let me just wait. Come on. Need a bow. Need a bow. Damn it. Oh, shit. Okay, I got this. I got this. Yeah, shit. Need a jack, bitch. Oh, damn it. I will get you. I will get you. Give me that shit. Give me that shit. Mine. 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 Oh, shit. Ow. See what you did? You see what you did? How did I do? Give me that shit. Give me that shit. Alright, this is the bow. You can upgrade it later on once you find parts. But for now, this is what we have to deal with. Alright.
Just remember Roth's training.
You can have the best form and technique in the world, but it won't mean a thing if you can't focus.
No.
The key to using any weapon is focus.
Alright guys, now what you want to do...
So hungry.
You wanna be in front of this warehouse, and you wanna go up here across the little river thing. You wanna pick up these arrows, but the main thing is up here. You are going to find a GPS cache up here. This will be your first, I believe. Oh fuck. Forgot to jump, hang on. This will be your first GPS cache, I believe. And you can pretty much just find it easily. Just follow the path. Jump to the other side. Climb the little thing right here. And it will be right there alongside with some more arrows. There we go.
Some kind of container.
You can also use your animal instincts to find things. However, that won't be pretty useful right now. Let me just show you the other location. Oh, where there's another cache, I believe. And then there's a document right there in the truck. You may want to get it. But the main thing that I want to focus on right now, there is a skull around here. So pay attention to the skull. And I will show you where it is at in a minute. Let me just grab this thing. I will not read that. You can just go back to it and read it. Or if you want to take your time, you can just pause the video and read it. Go down here. And make sure that you pick up these arrows because you are going to need them. Okay, we're full. Okay, man, whatever. We're full. Fine. Okay. The first should be around here. Oh, well, actually, not the first, but you get what I mean. Should be hanging from a tree. Somewhere, okay. This one right here. Let's just go ahead and shoot that one. And we started the challenge, as you can see. It's called Ghost Hunter. I believe we have to, yep, we have to get 10. Now there are some more. You can actually look for them really easily with your animal instincts. But we're gonna go up here. Remember, once you get that one, just go straight ahead over here across the river again. And there will be another GPS cache right here. This will be your second GPS cache, I believe.
Some kind of
it's a total of 5. It should be a total of 5 on this area. Alright, for the next ghost shell thinger a bother from the one that you just found right there, you want to go down. There should be another hanging on a tree somewhere around this area. So you want to pay close attention to that. There we go. Alright, we got that one. There should be some more around this area, so keep paying attention. Alright, just kill that deer because that will help us. There we go. Once you kill your first animal, you are going to actually skin it. Or whatever you want to call it, loot it, and then you can actually go back to the camp and increase your animal instincts. However, I'm gonna linger around this area just for a bit more because I need to find the rest of those ghost hunter skulls. Not to mention the one back at the camp. So let's get the ones in this area first, and then we can go back to the camp. She is a savage, man. Killed a poor animal. I do not condone animal violence, by the way. This is a theater game, so calm down. I love animals. I will never hurt them in my life. But sometimes, you know, I like to play football, right, okay? Brother. Here we go with the third one. It's hanging from this block.
To tell you where you are. If you can learn to read the land and the stars, you'll always be able to find your way home.
So those two are pretty close to each other. The one will be on that block. Maybe one from me. I'm just gonna go ahead and kill that bird then. Remember, be careful how you waste your arrows. You don't wanna waste them all completely. Yeah, that's fine around. There are some berries around this area, so make sure that you look for those berries as well. See, like right here? You need these. They are very, very important, so keep looking for them. There should be another skull around here. Ow! Dick! You know what? Get back here. You wanna play that game? You wanna play that game, bro? Squirt it. Squirt it, bro. Squirt it. Squirt it. That's right. Better run. I'm gonna let you live for now. I'm coming back for your ass. Alright, now we're outside. Yeah, so we're looking for these skulls. There should be some more around here. Should be some more. We climb up here. Just get these arrows. Make sure that you use your animal instinct, right? Because that will help you a lot, especially if you're trying to find all of these skulls. Alright, there is a crate right there, however we cannot get it just yet because we're gonna need to get the pry axe. And in order to get the pry axe, we're gonna have to actually go inside the warehouse that I just showed you earlier, but we're gonna have to go to the camp first. Alright, so I'm just gonna climb through this area right here in order to get those arrows. Alright, so there's some arrows in here next to that crate. Okay, we're full. Should be a couple more skulls around here. Then if not, I'm just gonna focus on the animals before I go back to the camp and actually get the one that's at the camp. They're really simple to find, especially if you use your vision. There is another catch right here by this fountain, so make sure you grab that. I don't know how the hell I missed it the first time, but hey, things happen, I guess. Alright, let's climb up here, see what's up here. But before I do that, let me just check the area. Alright, it looks good. It doesn't look like I missed anything else. Let's see what's over here. I can't remember if there's anything up here. I don't think there's anything up here. Alright, once you start killing the animals, eventually you'll get a little message saying that you can no longer receive as much XP for killing the animals. And that will basically just lower your XP because you have killed the animals around this area. Pretty sure that there are more skulls in here. Yeah, I think we got all of them in this area. So let's just focus on killing the animals. Killing a rabbit. Tricks are for kids. Where are you going? No, I'm not gonna waste the arrow. Tricks are for kids. Shoot. You also want to be careful of where you kill the animals at, because sometimes it will not let you loot them if you kill them pretty much in a different place. So just be careful of where you kill the animals. You want to be able to loot them, that's the whole point of getting this achievement, to loot the animal. You look surprised at me. Or shoot you in the ass. You want to go ahead and wait till they stop. Because if you shoot them while they're moving, then you're just gonna miss and waste your arrows. So let's just wait till it comes to a halt and shoot them in the face. Just like that. Trust me, it is way easier once you shoot them in the face. Wait till he stops. Follow him. Good shit, there we go. There we go. Kill this rabbit. I want to get a clear shot. Alright, come on, stop. Come on, stop. Come on, stop. You know what? Try looking at me. There we go. You want to just keep doing that until you have my better climate. Supposed to kill 10 of each. So big animals, small animals, and then birds. Remember that. Then you should have all three achievements. Shit, I missed. Try not to miss. That's the whole point here. You don't want to miss. If you miss, then it's gonna end real badly for you, and then you're gonna end up wasting your arrows. Now there is a skill set that allows you to, you know, retract your arrows from the bodies, but that will come later. Let's go ahead and find another deer so that we can shoot him in the face. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. Sorry. It just drops. Alright, got some more arrows around here. Always look around these parts for berries, because you're gonna need berries. Berries will keep you alive. Berries, berries, hella berries. Hella berries, like Macklemore, man. Want to find them. Always linger around this area for a bit long. Just a couple of minutes. There we go. This is the open. Good luck for you. And you, oh, hey, hey, don't you dare freaking hit me again. Stand still. Stand still. I'm trying to shoot you in the face. Why? Why won't you allow me to shoot you in the face? Cut him off. I'm like the greatest hunter ever, where is he? Alright, the greatest hunter ever just lost his prey. I should be ashamed of myself for losing my prey. There we go. Shit. That's why I keep looking at me. So many dead bodies. So many dead bodies. Well, that's how this game is. That's how we're gonna play it. It's all about the game and how you play it. It's all about control and how you can take it. Go to the same guy then. Alright, Reject Hunted Out. This is the message. Only a small amount of XP can now be gathered. Once you get that message, your XP will be lower now. So pay attention to that. And now we can go back to the camp, because I believe I pretty much just killed every deer in here. So let us go back to the camp, and let us regain that, let us get that part back. But before I do that, there's a skull right here. I do not know how the hell I missed that. Not okay. That was so simple, man. I don't know how the heck I missed that. And it's by the warehouses. Well, all right, let's go. We're gonna go back, and then we're gonna go and get the one that's hanging by the fire camp. It's a really easy shot, and you can get it simply. Let's just get back here. And there it is, you can see it just hanging there on that tree. You want to shoot it. And there we go, we got 5. Now I believe the others are after you go and get the pryaxe. So let's just go and access the camp here so that we can increase our skills. I'm going to go ahead and increase the animal instinct. And now the animals and foods will be highlighted, as well as these skulls. We can go over these. I'm not really gonna go over them because they're pretty much self-explanatory. So there's no need for me to go over them.
This is Conrad Roth, captain of the Endurance. We are shipwrecked on an island inside the Dragon's Triangle.
Roth!
Lara!
You're alive!
Easy, easy. Are you okay? What happened?
I remember the beach. Then it went black and I woke up in a cave. There was this crazy man, Roth, and a dead body.
Oh, God. Where are you now, Lara? Are you safe?
It was so horrible. It's all my fault. This is all my fault.
Lara, listen to me. I sent an SOS from the Endurance before I abandoned her. Hopefully someone caught it. I've spoken to the others. We're regrouping at my location.
Please come and get me.
I have to stay here. You can do this, Lara. Remember when we climbed Snowdon? You said the key was knowing that all you've got to do is just keep moving. Remember everything I've taught you, Lara. You're ready for this. And keep your radio on.
Okay.
No. If all we had to do was just keep moving, we wouldn't be in this type of situation, would we? Shit, man. Alright, now we're gonna go back to the warehouse and the door will be magically open. See what I mean?
Hello?
For some reason it will be magically open.
Is someone there?
What we're gonna do here is that we're going to gather with the other survivors. But first, let us go down these ladder here. Yeah.
This could be a way through.
We need to go down to the dark place. The dark side.
Damn it.
Magic shut that door. Oh my god. I'm scared. I'm scared, man. I think it's scaring me, bruh. Alright, so we're gonna go down here and we're going to actually go get the pry axe, which will allow us to open those crates. The crates and the doors. So we'll be able to open the doors and the crane. I look at saying cranes. Why? Crates, man. Crates, my god. Pay attention to the symbol, by the way. If you pay attention, some of them will actually lead you to a tomb that you can explore and actually get some treasures from. Alright, here we'll have a document. So make sure you pick that up.
This traditional no mask represents
or not a black white paint. It is
there are
a
traces
mask.
Of white paint on the inside. Whoever used this mask was of noble birth.
Yep, you can go ahead and look at it. I'm just gonna skip it for now. We'll keep open this. Get some parts. You can actually go ahead and ignite that. And the pry axe will be right here. Now you can actually use that to open doors, crates, and climb walls. But you're gonna have to upgrade it in order for it to do stronger stuff. So make sure you upgrade that. We're not gonna go back because I pretty much just, well, actually, yes, I am. I'm gonna go back. Just to make sure I got every freaking skull. I'm pretty sure that there should only be 5. But let's just go ahead and make sure, now that we have our senses increased, we should be able to find more. Also, the arrows should be respawning, so we could just go ahead and stack up on those arrows again. Open this door like a bowels, you know, because of the bowels. Alright. Nothing there, let me just move up ahead. A little more. You should be able to open things like that, barricaded, but that will be later on the game. Actually, doesn't look like there's anything around here. Let's just keep looking. Move up every time. Just to make sure. There's the crane over there, or the crate. Fuck, I keep saying crate. There should be a couple of berries left around here as well. We to go and get that crate up there. I'm gonna go get these arrows first. Learn how to navigate around this map. This is gonna need to. Really easy to navigate around this map. Alright, let's open this crate. Get some salvage parts, get these arrows, okay, we're full. Everything seems fine. Let's go ahead and jump down. Let's look at the other side. You want to be thorough, okay? You want to make sure that you got everything, because you might need, you know, you might need some things in the future. You never know. Here we got some more berries. I told you there will be more berries. Let's just do another quick check here. Find the place. See an animal and then shoot it, because that will be crucial for the achievement. May sound cruel, but hey, it's a game, no animals for hunting. Or in real life, no animals for hunting. See a bunny, definitely. You know, if you see a bunny, you should definitely shoot it in the face, because, you know, like, tricks are for kids now. Make sure to be eating tricks. Alright, looks like we got everything in this area, so let's just head back. And continue on. We need to go and reboot with the other idiots. So let's just go and reboot with the other idiots. Yeah. They're really stupid idiots. So climb these stairs down really slowly. So pay attention to those markings, because they could lead to tombs, and you're gonna have to go into the tombs if you want to find the treasures and stuff like that. Probably open that door like a boss. Go through here. Use the power of the booty to get to like that tight space right there. That booty be popping in. Go that way. You know me, man. Booty be popping. Look at my booty. Look at my booty. I want booty. Alright. Let's extinguish that torch like a badass. Let's check around. Every time you go into a new area, check around just in case.
We have a fire. Look for the smoke.
We're on our way.
But you never know where our skull should be, or could be.
Laura, you made it. Sam, thank goodness. Surprise.
It's okay, he's one of us.
Sorry if I startled you. This place would make anyone a little jumpy. We just spoke to your crew. They're on their way.
Look, he bandaged my foot.
Oh, it was the least I could do. My manners. I'm sorry, I'm Matthias. A teacher by trade. Not really cut out for island life, I'm afraid.
Sweetie, you look exhausted. Sit down.
Yeah.
Sam here was just telling me about the Sun Queen.
Right, Himiko.
Can you tell me more? I'm intrigued.
Well, believe it or not, a couple thousand years ago, Queen Himiko pretty much ran things in Japan.
She loves telling this story.
Himiko was
beautiful, enigmatic, but also ruthless and powerful. Legend says she had shamanistic powers.
And this is where she loses me.
Well, there's always some truth to myths.
She commanded an army of samurai warriors, her magnificent storm guard. They rode the very winds into battle, laying waste to all who opposed them. They say the sun rose at Himiko's command, and she ruled everything its rays touched, from the mountains to the sea and beyond.
But what happened to you?
Right, and we are back. Now that had to hurt, to be honest. Alright, we're gonna fight some wolves here, so be ready. Don't worry, they'll be slowed down for you. You can pretty much get a shot at them real quickly. Let's just wait for one of them to come out. Jacob, run! Whoops, sorry. I'm sorry, I'm pretty sure that I just kill one of Jacob's cousins here. Smile. Oh, there goes Jacob's brother. Jacob, run! Hey, Jacob. Well, I just pretty much slaughtered Jacob's family. Nope, they should have learned then. Should have learned, and that's what I'm hunting.
Let go.
It's good to see you, little bird.
I'm so glad you're here. Is Sam with you?
She was with you.
She was here with that man, Matthias. But I passed out. When I woke up, they were both gone.
You girls shouldn't go wandering off.
We need to find them.
Wait. What about Raw?
Okay, let's split up. One of us go with Lara and meet up with Roth. The rest of us should fan out and look for Sam.
I'll go with her.
No. Let me.
You know how to use one of these?
It's been a while. It's all coming back to me.
Get to Roth. We'll find Sam and this Matthias guy.
You gonna be okay?
Yes, I probably just need to rest for a few minutes.
You sit here. I'll check up ahead.
Okay. Not so bad.
Alright guys, that would be all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully I helped you guys with the skulls as well as with the GPS catches. I will be doing more, guys, so stay tuned for the next episode. But for now, like I said, thank you so much for watching. Do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'm Dr. Murdershy, and